Today we'll be seeing the topic electric dipole, and you're a bit familiar with this topic during your 10th 12th standards. Now let us see briefly in relation with electromagnetic fields. See, the term dipole is usually for a two equal and opposite charges that are separated by a small distance d comparative to a distance of a point p at which we desire to find the electric field as well as the potential. And this dipole is also called as a doublet because of its two charges but of its opposite direction. So now let us consider a point P. Now considering this point P, let us also have the distance between this point P and Q and point P and minus Q. So let this distance be R1 and let this distance be R2 and let this distance be your R. Okay, and the angle made by this will be theta. Okay, so now let the positive charge Q and the negative charge Q be the two point charges, and so this, the distance which means the coordinate of your Z will be 0, 0, d/2, whereas the coordinate of minus Q will be 0, 0, -d/2. Okay, so now taking it to the much for easy understanding, so let us now extend this figure same as this way. So we are considering only the points. Okay, so as we have already seen during your equipotential, when you are going to break this line, all these lines seems to be parallel to each other. Okay, when you are going on extending this line. So with that same concept, let me also take this point to be in this way. Okay, in this way and in this way. So which means this is my positive Q and this is my negative Q, and the angle made is theta. So extending this point, so all this will have a point P. Okay, here again it is R1, R and R2, and the distance already we have seen is d. Okay, so let us consider now for simplification what always we have to do. Whatever is the point in your Z plane, you are going to extend it to your X plane, right? So this is nothing but our X plane. Okay, this is nothing but our Y plane. So now we are going to extend this point to your YX plane. So now what happens? This theta will also be present here, theta, and this will be my angle. Okay, so now consider these two points to be A and B, and let this point be M. Okay, so now what will happen, we'll see. Now after considering these points, now what will happen? Now our BM will be AB cos theta according to your trigonometric rules. That is, cos theta will be your BM by AB. So from this, like what we'll get, AB is nothing but my distance B, and PB will be my PM. Okay, and PB will be equal to RT. This condition is because you have a perpendicular line AM. Okay, so PB will be equal to R2, PA will be equal to my R1. So now what we need to find, PB. Okay, so this PB will be equal to PB plus PM. So taking it to the other side, we will have PB minus PM, where your PB is nothing but my R2, and PM, this is nothing but same as well as my AP, okay, which is nothing but my R1. So I'll have R2 minus R1. So let us consider this to be your expression number 2. Now equating your expression number 1 and 2, what we have? R2 minus R1 is equal to D into cos theta. So let this be our expression number 3. Okay. So to find the electric field and the potential at this point P, so we have to consider individual charges. As we have seen, that potential is due to a single charges, considering the other charges to be at infinite, other point to be at infinite. So what will be a V due to positive Q, and what will be my V due to a negative Q? Okay, so first let us consider V due to my positive Q, which will be a positive Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R1, and V due to my negative Q will be minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R2. So these are the two conditions what I have now. So now what will be my total potential I need to find? So the total potential will be due to my P, and that is because of my dipole. What will I get is V is positive Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R1 minus, because of this charge, minus Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R2. Now taking a common term, Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, I will just have 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. And after this, what we need to do, we need to go for your LCM and then cross multiplying it. So what will be now the case, we'll just have Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R2 minus R1 divided by R2 into R1. Now, if the point P is in the xy plane, if it is in the same xy plane, we will not have this point, right? A separate point like this and like this we will not have, because of your positive Q. This is because of your positive, this is because of your negative, and this was your angle theta. So if this point is exactly at P, say this is at P, which is, we do not have any potential. So now this V will be 0. Now if this point P is located somewhere very much farther distance compared to these two charges, what will be happening? Now your R1 and R2 will have my same radius R. Okay, and my R2 minus R1, that is second charge, will be equal to my d cos theta, what we have already seen. Okay, already that we have seen. Now putting into this, like what we'll have, V is, substituting all this in this expression, say let this be our fourth expression, so we'll have Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught to be R2 minus R1, I have D into cos theta, divided by R2, and R2 are same as R, so which is nothing but my R square. So let this again be my expression, say first expression. Now, like already we know that in the previous lecture we have seen, what is your E? E was nothing but your potential drop, what we got because of your gradient, that is nothing but my del into V. So now what we have to find, already since we have found what is V, we need to find E vector with respect to my V. So now we just need to substitute this Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into D cos theta divided by R square, okay, into this equation. So with this relation, like already since we have been considered with the coordinate system, and we have even seen what is the coordinate system for which is dealing with theta and phi, okay, so we just have E vector to be minus of dou V by dou R into AR plus 1 by R dou V by dou theta into A theta plus dou V by R sin theta into dou phi into A phi. Okay, so now with this respect equation, we just need to find what is my V. So now what will be my V I have to find? So dou v by dou r is nothing but dou by dou r of, and substituting a v value, I'll have qd cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into r squared. So I'll just have, since this is being a partial derivative with respect to r squared, I'll have a r cube, okay? So qd cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r cube, and this is minus 2 here taking it. So I'll just have minus qd cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into r cube. In similar way, what will be my dou v by dou theta? With respect to theta, I have only a cos theta value. So I'll have minus qd into sin theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r squared. And since there is no term related with phi, I'll just have dou v by dou phi is equal to 0. Now, inputting all this data in your above E vector, now what will I have finally is, E vector is nothing but my qd cos theta divided by 2 pi epsilon naught r cube into ar plus qd sin theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r cube into a theta. Okay, so this is my entire electric field, what I arrive at considering a dipole moment. Okay, thank you.